special. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as of now, the 23rd of December 2010, Bengaluru is known for three amazing things. One, of course, the liquor, which is flowing freely because of Christmas Eve. Two, the unstable political state in the entire city. And three, this very gorgeous, stunning woman who's just got the coveted Miss Earth title back to the city. Nicole, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So tell me, man, tell me, Nicole, when they said, when the anchor announced, well, Miss Earth 2010, Nicole Ferrier, how do you feel?
Well, my parents are sitting right there, and I was hoping that he would be called out, and that's exactly what happened. And I think right from the very beginning of the opening entry of our dance sequence, I had this gut feeling that I would win. And as my name kept being called out for the next round, I just thought that it was one step closer to getting there.
You seem so confident. I'm sure, well, during your entire grooming process, I understand your mother took care, groomed your beauty and your physique, and your father groomed your communication skills. What would happen?
Both.
Why?
Because it's an equal, I believe that life is about balance and focus, and you have to have a complete balance between two things, or two or more things, but an even balance to make it all right. So I think that they did play, both of them did play a very important role.
Absolutely, and yes, it shows, it's so evident. Now, I understand your mother is a Punjabi from Delhi.
Yes.
And your father is, of course, a Roman Catholic from this city. Yes. So how was it like growing in a multicultural environment?
It was very exciting. I got to celebrate a lot of festivals. And I never complained because, you know, you get the best of two worlds. And it was fabulous growing up that way.
Well, you look very stunning right now, but did you know always that you're going to be, you know, you're going to end up as a beauty queen?
I don't really think I'd end up as a beauty queen. I've always thought, you know, when I was 15 years old, I thought that I'd be an actress. And I got into modeling, I did my first show, and I remember that I felt my best, and I felt so powerful, because all eyes were on me. I liked the camera, flashlights, you know, the limelight, the attention, and I've never looked back ever since.
Okay, so, then, are you a daddy's girl?
Yes, I am.
And what, share your relationship with your dad?
Me and my dad are very open with each other. As kids, we'd have these little debates at lunch or at breakfast, and my mom and my brother would be on one team, and me and my dad would be on the other team. And I was always daddy's little princess. You know, whatever I said with, like, my little lip rolled, like, rolled down, and like that, and I'd say whatever, I get what I want to. So, that way, yes, I have been daddy's little girl, but not always. We were brought up in a very strict environment.
Yeah.
Dad is a disciplinarian, and mom was the one that kind of spoiled us. So, we had a perfect balance between the two.
So, tell me, so, how has your mom spoiled you?
Mom used to buy us the fanciest clothes, the fanciest phones, shoes, bags, you know, in school, the fanciest pencil boxes and, you know, book bags and stuff. So that way, she did spoil us to a very large extent.
Yeah.
And then there's Dad complaining and saying, oh my God, you're spoiling the kids, stop it, this, that. So basically, again, the balance.
Okay, so growing up, what was Daddy's worst punishment?
Oh, the chair position.
Oh, is it a torture session?
Yes, not torture session. I mean, okay. It's no, but, you know, we, as kids, we'd be allowed to go around for 2 hours and play and come back and study and do whatever else at home. My friends were allowed to come home, but we weren't supposed to be out for more than 2 hours a day. And this was when we were really small. And if we came home late, then we'd have to you know, lean against the wall.
Mm-hmm.
No, sorry, not lean against the wall. We had to act like you're a chair. So, act like you're leaning against the wall with your knees bent and your legs dropped right onto the floor. So, basically, we sit there for 5 minutes and we're like, we're never going to do it again, please. And he let us go. So, that was like a little punishment.
Tell me one incident throughout your life where your dad caught you doing something very nasty and punished you very harshly. Something more than the chair person, the chair position.
I don't think there's ever been a time that way.
Has he ever been overly protective of you?
Of course he has been overly protective, but he's never been harsh or brutal, or he's never really bruised us or beaten us up like a like an evil man. They're a cruel person. He's not a cruel person. He's a very humble person. And he just tries to, I guess, he's also a counselor. So he understands psychology very well. And I guess that's his way of teaching us from right to wrong.
Which brings me to a very nice question, which I asked you some time back. Dad or Mom? And this time you need to be very, very frank with me.
Mom and Dad.
Okay, let's play it your way. But tell me, I understand that Prasad Bidappa spotted you when you were quite young. So how did that happen?
I started off my first show with a different coordinator. I did a few shoots with him. And then, of course, Prasad saw me. We're family friends. We go back a long way. And he asked me to model, and I wasn't too interested because I wanted to be an actress. And my dad was like, you know, why don't you just do one show? And you never know, you can never lose anything. So I said, Dad, you know what? Actually, what if I fall on stage? There'll be so many cameras. People will laugh at me. I mean, what will be the state what's going to happen to me after that? And more than that, I was like, people are going to stare at me while I'm walking. And I feel really uncomfortable. So he goes, you know what? Face your fears. And that's exactly how my dad is. Face your fears. So that's exactly what I did. And my very first show happened to be the show I fell in love with. And I've never looked back ever since. I love the attention.
And the rest is history, of course. So I believe that you've always wanted to become an actress. Obviously, looking at your beauty and intelligence you possess, right now I'm sure a lot of directors and producers are looking at you and judging you and thinking of what role to offer you. Tell me, what role would you take and why?
I would take a role with a meaning in it and with something that can send out a message. As college love stories and everything are a lot of fun. Action movies are fun. But something that sends out a strong message and has a meaning means most to me.
I'm sure you look great in an action-oriented role. I'm sure they do agree. So, of course, you love acting. Name your favorite actor in the world of India.
World of India?
Yeah. Silence?
I have a lot of...
Okay, but name one.
Name one. Just one.
Okay, name five. Let's go the essential order way.
Only name the other.
Okay, let's take a worldwide.
Thank you. Johnny Depp. Shah Rukh Khan.
Okay.
Rajinikanth. And Amitabh Bachchan.
So you mentioned Rajinikanth.
Yes.
Rajinikanth. Why Rajinikanth?
Because I think he's a superstar. In my eyes, he is a hero. And I love his tricks. I love the way he acts. He is born natural when it comes to acting on screen. And I'd like to meet him someday.
I'm sure you're going to meet him very soon. I'm sure if he's looking at you right now, he's thinking when and where. Because I'll tell you something, Rajinikanth, give me one signature dialogue of Rajinikanth.
Are you serious?
Mimicking.
Can you give me a dialogue that I can repeat?
Now, one more time. More time.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay,
I'll give you a simpler one.
Very simple.
Yarvari, Thandivari, Marakkadu.
What? Say it again.
Yarvari, Yarvari,
Thandivari,
Marakkadu. Now you go.
Yarvari, Thandivari, Marakkadu.
Thandivari,
Marakkadu.
Did you see my other wife? Your wife is sorry. Did we meet this lady? She's a number one. I'm sorry. All right. Before we slip into a very short break, yeah. You mentioned Johnny Depp.
Yes, I did.
Mimic Johnny Depp. Come on. I'm done.
Mimic him? He's so different in each of his films. That's why I love him. He's a very versatile actor. And I'd like to be like that. Very versatile. He plays very challenging roles. And that's what I love.
Can you do, give me a rendition of probably a Jack Sparrow or something like that? Come on, you watched it.
Really? Maybe you should.
Yeah.
You're a guy.
The guy asked me questions before.
You've got the hairstyle and everything.
You really think so?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look at the camera and you have
to
dialogue.
This is when I'm supposed to be very happy. This is when I'm supposed to be flashing my biggest smile. Before that, I'm going to ask you to take a break. Johnny Depp style.
Take a break and then I come back into the Johnny Depp style.
Okay, fine. Folks, short break. Right back.